Ẹnlẹ́ o, orúkọ mi ni Tóyìn, mo wá láti orílẹ̀-èdè Nàìjíríà. What you've just said is Yoruba, and I introduce myself saying, hello, my name is Tóyìn, and I am from Nigeria. I'll be sharing with you a story of a Yoruba king so powerful that he became a lightning god. Oyo was a Yoruba-speaking empire in modern-day Benin and Togo, as shown on the map. It lasted from the 1300s until the early 1800s. Oyo was depicted in the 2022 United States movie about the Dahomey people, the Woman King. Oyo's fourth king, Sango, is considered by some to have become the Thunder King after his death, somewhat like Zeus or Thor. Oral poetry has it that Sango struggled to gain control over lightning. As a child in Takwa, Sango was always getting into trouble. He was short-tempered, impatient, bossy, and didn't take kindly to any complaint. Sango's only pastimes were war games and fights. The first place Sango visited was called Koso. When he arrived, the terrified town people asked, "Who is this dangerous character?" But Sango threatened them with his oshe. His breath turned into fire and it destroyed a few houses with his lightning stones. Sango had three queens, Oya, Oshun, and Oba. Oya, the favorite, is said to control the wind that often comes before lightning storms. Gentle breeze is the father of rain. Soft wind is the father of cloud dust. If you want to control the storm, ask Oya, and the iroko leaf shall not fall on the horse's back. Meanwhile, Oshu controls the darkness that accompanies storm, and Oba represent the rain cloud. Sango, Oya, Oshu, and Oba appear together in the sky during the storm, as well as in the worship practices of some people.